Everybody, it is Sunday, and there I am down in the little corner here with my crazy headgear on, but we're about to start week two, and let's see, this week we've done our introduction forum and had that first paper, which is due today by midnight. I will make every effort to get that paper graded and back to you by the end of the week. I try to get those done quite quickly. And I think you'll see that you'll get those pretty soon. You have your first case study discussion due on Wednesday. And that case study discussion needs to be substantive posts. And if you looked at the handbook, it says that you're required to have three posts. That's the minimum requirement. And of those three posts, you need to have your initial one, which is going to answer the questions. And we're going to take a look at that. So I'm going to go to that so we can discuss it a little more completely. So let's go back here. And my computer's running slow again. Let's go to week two. And we'll start at the beginning for our devotion and reflection. And our overview of the information in week two talks a lot about pregnancy and the importance of diet and foods to avoid and foods to include in your diet. At the completion of this week, you should be able to complete a comprehensive health assessment on a patient, on an OB patient. And we have chapters 4 and 7, and we've got some resources here for you and PowerPoints. I'm working on doing the recordings of the PowerPoints. I've only gotten the first two done. I had them all done in the old book, in the old textbook, but these are a little different, so I'm redoing them all. Now, also, I wanted to make a point for those of you who have the second edition textbook. Really, I mean, there are some differences in the textbook. The big thing is there is no chapter 31 and 32, so what I'm going to do is record chapter 31 and 32, so you're not worrying about not having the appropriate textbook. And also, the study guides that I'm going to develop for the exams, I think they'll be comprehensive enough to fill in any gaps that may be present with the textbook. So I don't want you to go out and get a new one. I had contacted the publisher to see if there was anything that we could do to upgrade the materials, and that was over a week ago, and they've not responded. So I'm just going to do it myself. So I don't want you to worry about that. Now here's our first case study discussion. So I'm going to open that here. And remember, we're not going to do learning teams in this group. Everybody's going to answer the questions, and then you're going to interact with each other. And this particular case study you're going to do this week is Our Pregnant Daughter Didn't Want This. And if we click on this link, it's going to send us to an article that talks about a woman who, unfortunately, in her pregnancy, was involved in an incident that made her receive the diagnosis of brain death. While she was pregnant. And this goes over the moral dilemma that the family was left with in regard to the pregnancy. No, the pregnancy wasn't at viability. So in the pregnant state, a woman is considered to have a viable pregnancy if she's 24 weeks gestation, or if the fetus is 515 grams, or excuse me, over 500 grams. So this baby's much younger than that. But I want you to really explore this ethical dilemma, and I want you to discuss it amongst each other. Now, according to the MSN handbook, the requirements of discussion posts are three, and that is to answer the questions. And I want you to answer the questions that are listed here. So that's what's going to be due on Wednesday. Then you are going to discuss with each other. The minimum requirement is this initial, the answer to these questions, and then you need to make a comment on one of your classmates' posts, and then you are going to respond to a classmate who has made a comment on your post. Now, that's the minimum requirement, and you have to be mindful that these posts need to be substantive in APA format and cited. And if you want to get the full credit of points for this, you need to go above and beyond that. So 3 is the minimum requirement. But if you want to get that full 25 points, you need to go a little bit more. You have to go a little above and beyond that. So that's what we're going to do for week 2. And if you have any questions, please feel free. Remember, the best way to contact me is through email. That's probably the best way. Second best is text. Please don't use the questions for the professor link that's here, because it takes multiple steps to get to it. So I would rather use a method that's a little bit easier for us to communicate back and forth with each other. Remember, I look at these, I look at my phone constantly. So if I've not responded to your remark or your question within a couple of hours, in all likelihood I didn't get it, so send it again, or then try and give me a text that time. I hope you have a wonderful week, and I look forward to reading all of your papers. Good night.